Iowa Republicans have made it official now. They will hold their caucuses on January the 3rd of next year, the same date as back in 2008. Iowa also showed solidarity with New Hampshire, backing a boycott of the Nevada caucuses unless it moves back its date to allow New Hampshire to hold its primary in January. Now, the 2008 Republican nominee, John McCain, is weighing in as well. Let's go to Josh McElvin, who joins us with more.
Yeah, and John McCain went so far to say he's not even sure he would have won the New Hampshire primary twice if it were held in December. But now that Iowa has set its date, the focus is on Nevada and what Mitt Romney will do in the face of increasing pressure.
Announcing a caucus date of January 3rd, Iowa's governor and Republican chairman also stand with New Hampshire, calling on Nevada to move its caucus date back a mere 72 hours.
That's not too much to ask. They would still be third in this process.
What I do know, there still is an opportunity to make sure we maintain sanity in the schedule where it is Iowa and it is New Hampshire. And the ball, to some degree, is in Nevada's court. They have the opportunity to move back just 3 days.
With the specter of a December primary looming, if Nevada doesn't move its date, several candidates have threatened a boycott of Nevada's caucuses. And on Tuesday, John McCain lent his considerable voice to the effort.
If I were a candidate today, I would certainly boycott Nevada, without a doubt. And I say that as a resident of a neighboring state.
Speaking of neighbors, former Massachusetts governor and New Hampshire frontrunner Mitt Romney faces increasing pressure from leading Republicans to show loyalty to New Hampshire and join the Nevada boycott. And heading into the debate tonight, ABC's George Stephanopoulos says Romney is in a tough spot.
What Mitt Romney's going to have to be worried about tonight is some pressure from the Nevada people to get in the middle of this whole question of boycotting the Nevada caucuses, which I think he does not want to do. So he's happy to answer that, I think, in Nevada, but he knows how that might reverberate in New Hampshire.
Already accused of taking New Hampshire for granted, Romney was in damage control on Tuesday, rolling out new endorsements from state reps and hopping on a conference call with local supporters where he did not acknowledge the boycott.
I'm sure you know I support New Hampshire's primary. I support your process and your Secretary of State, Bill Gardner.
All right, now late this afternoon, another leading Republican in New Hampshire, Ovid Lamontagne, endorsed the boycott, saying, quote, whatever it takes. Lamontagne made that statement while hosting an event for John Huntsman, who is also boycotting the debate tonight in Las Vegas in favor of a town hall in Hopkinton. Reporting live, Josh McElvin, WMUR News 9.